Hi ladies, my name is Nadesh, and once again, welcome back to Becoming His Ministry, where we empower women to live a godly, thriving relationship with Jesus Christ, mentally, physically, and spiritually. I am so excited that we are back. I have a special topic that I want us to talk about. The topic is entitled Our Purpose / Our Worth. These two words mean so much to us in forming our foundation with Jesus Christ. And I just pray that it's truly a blessing to you. To begin, let us have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, I am so thankful and grateful for the opportunity that you have given us to come together as sisters in Christ, to learn more of you and learn how to be completely yours, to find our true purpose and our true identity, Lord. I ask for your Holy Spirit to please abide with us as we study your word. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. To begin, do you think that we struggle with finding our purpose, or is it a combination of purpose and our worth? You see, I say it like this because a lot of time, you know, we hear people say, before someone say that they are looking for their purpose or, you know, identity, it stems from the feeling of wanting to belong, to be accepted, to be appreciated, to be valued, and to be fulfilled, whether it is by others or through family, job, careers, or extracurricular activities. People are always looking for that sense of belonging, something that they love, something that they find that people can appreciate them for. But in search of that, the world tells us what we need to do is we need to go out there and go get it. We need to go find ourselves, get our hands on different things and find our purpose and true worth. But you know what? Honestly, I am so tired of the world telling us how we need to live, the type of women that we need to be. I want to know, what's God's definition for purpose and value? What does the Word of God have to say about that? And before we begin, I really encourage you to grab a notebook or in a pen to simply take notes for yourself so that you can go back to the Word of God and be filled by the bread of life. Because at the end of the day, that's what matters. That's what's important, that you are filled, that you are encouraged. Because you might come to a point in your life where you don't have access to the internet or you can't remember the name of the ministry, but you are able to go back to your notes and partake of Christ for yourself and be filled. I'm gonna be looking down a lot because I'm, you know, using my Bible and sharing the scriptures with you. So I want us to turn our Bible to Isaiah 43 verses 7, and let's see what the Word of God says. Even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. This verse is so packed. In this verse alone, it tells us who we are and whose we are. It tells us who created us and why he created us. It gives us our identity and our origin. You see, he says that I made you and your purpose is to give me glory. This verse alone is just answered our question in so many different ways. But you might be asking, like, how, why, when? You know, I want us to turn our Bibles to Jeremiah 1 verses 4 to 5. And it says, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew you. And before thou camest thou out of the womb, I sanctified thee and ordained thee a prophet. And we're going to go ahead and dive into Isaiah 49 verse 16 as well. It says, behold, I have engraved thee upon the palms of my hand. Thy walls are continually before me. So let's go back. So the Bible has given us a definition. A clear definition of our purpose and our value. Our purpose is to give God glory, which we found in Isaiah 47 verse 3 that I read earlier. What we do is truly a simply a manifestation of, or an extension of accomplishing, of fulfilling that purpose. So I absolutely love the Bible's definition that it says, you know, I am created to give him glory, you know, in every aspect of my life. Before he formed me in the womb, you know, he made me. In my mother's womb, before I had any titles, before I was a mother, daughter, a doctor, or former teacher, a social worker, whatever it is, it says before I had those titles, he created me for his glory and to be a blessing to others and to glorify his name. This is why trying to find our purpose and our worth in anything outside of Christ is so dangerous, because we are trying to fill a hole that only Christ was meant to fill. And this is why, you know, it leads to depression, anxiety, divorces, and so many spiral down to so many different things, because we are in search of something that nothing and no one can give to us. I want to pause this to say, sis, If you didn't know this before, I want to share this with you because Christ shared it with me. If you didn't know this before, just you, Christ said to me, Nadesh, just you are enough for me. Just you are enough for God. Not the title you possess or what you do. Just you are enough. And I pause to say this because a lot of times we think that it's the titles that we have that gives us purpose or value or that gives us worth in life. And we find ourselves, you know, seeking for those things. Yet after you've done achieving that, what's next? What else? You know, and we find ourselves in ministry serving God, yet he's gonna say, I never knew you, because we never accepted him fully for our lives. We never accepted his purpose and his plan for our lives. He created us for his glory. We think that it's the things that we do that save us. No, what we do is simply a manifestation of the love of Christ that we have for him, but it does not save us. So I wanted to pause and say that. So it's knowing your purpose and your worth. It's not found in your titles and the things that you do. It's really in knowing who you are and who you belong to. And that is Christ Jesus. You know, the things that we do or are led to do is simply an avenue that will give, that Christ used to simply manifest his purpose in giving him glory. So when I hear people say, you know, I am a mother, a doctor, a nurse, a social worker, a farmer, a teacher, whatever title you possess, that's who I am and that's who I'm always going to be. That is mind-blowing to me, because what happens when you can no longer perform these things, or you have those titles but you can't do anything with it? You know, these past couple of years, past 2 to 3 years, have showed us just that. So what happens to your purpose and your value then? Does it just, you no longer have it? Does it disappear? So that is a very limiting mindset to Christ, you know. And God wants to set his daughters free and accept his meaning of purpose and finding our worth. I just want to share that because it is indeed really powerful, and it's driving a lot of daughters of God, a lot of women, to people in general, really, to really seek and search and finding where they belong and their values and things that will never fill them. So I have an analogy to share with you. For anybody who knows me, you know that I absolutely love mangoes, right? By the way, mango season is here. I can see the trees budding, and you know, I see the little fruits coming up. So just, you know, remember me. So a mango tree bears mangoes, right? It knows to bear mangoes. But a mango tree, its purpose is to bear mangoes. It does not discriminate whether or not it bears high branches, medium branches, or low branches, right? And when it has those branches, it also does not discriminate which of those branches, which level of those branches bears the mangoes. You know, if the mangoes just bear, the high branches bear the mangoes, and the medium and low branches just have branches in them. But when you see a mango tree bears mangoes in all of its branches, whether they're low, medium, or high. Personally, I cannot imagine if a mango tree decided that it would only bear fruit on its high branches. I would have a hard time, because if you know me, I am not the tallest person. So I want to be able to go to that mango tree and grab a mango for myself and partake of its sweetness and truly enjoy it. Can you imagine if I had to wait it all the time for someone tall enough to be able to pass by? Someone like my husband, he's 6, but to be able to pass by and grab me a mango, he's not always, you know, there. That's just, to me, I don't know, this may not mean anything to you, but to me that would be extremely hard. You know, like I shared with you, I am this, I have this title and that title, this is what I'm always going to be or do. If a mango tree does not discriminate how it bears its blessing or how it fulfills, manifests to glorify God, who are we to do that? Limiting him, saying, Lord, this is how far you can use me and no further. Who are we to say that? We're not only not glorifying him, and when we prevent ourselves from being a blessing to others, we also prevent ourselves from receiving blessing. And I just came by really quickly to just share this with someone, because not knowing our worth and our value that is found in Christ Jesus, it's so easy just live out there in pursuit of something, of the wind, basically, that we feel that will bring us true purpose and value. But when the reality is, Your purpose and your worth was already engraved in you, in your mother's womb. God said it. He said it in His word. So if you didn't get anything from what I shared with you today, go back in your notes. Remember this. God created you for His glory. Your worth and your value is found in Him. He said, I've engraved you in the palm of my hands. Can you imagine that? How precious you are to Him. He engraved you. That means no one else can erase that and from His hand, from His heart. That's how valuable you are to Him. So I don't know where you have been seeking that fulfillment or that drive to different things to just find fulfillment in life and your purpose and your worth. But I just want to remind you that God loves you. He loves you, not what you can do for Him, but He loves you. The things that we do should only be a manifestation of the love of Christ that we have in fulfilling His purpose, which is to give Him glory. And I invite you to make that exchange with Him, because this is not something that we can do on our own, because we have been brainwashed by the world standard of what purpose or our self-worth looks like or should be. If you're wanting to accept that and make that a change, I invite you to pray with me. Heavenly gracious Father, thank you so much, Lord, for setting us free, for showing us that our true purpose is to give you glory, Father God, for showing that our worth is found in you, for showing us that, Father, you created us. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We have value in your eyes and in your heart, and we are important to you. And now we don't need to do anything to get that. But the things that should flow from our heart are simply a means of that, an avenue that you use, oh God. So you know what each woman is struggling with. I don't know, Lord. I don't know what they're struggling with, whether it's from one degree after another degree, a job after another job, whatever it is, or depression or anxiety that all of this might cause. I'm praying, Lord, that they will make that exchange and accept your definition of purpose, your definition of value for their lives, and that your name will be glorified and magnified. Thank you, God, for setting us free. We give you all of the glory and all of the praise. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much. See you on the next video. And don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and share this with someone who you truly think that it would be a blessing to them.